Welcome friends, today we are going to discuss the sex-linked inheritance and we will see how this inheritance is different from the autosomal genes inheritance. And we will also try to differentiate the two important words, sex-linked characters and sex-limited characters. So one by one we will discuss. Firstly, since the sex-linked inheritance has been established by the experiments conducted by Morgan, so we'll start with Morgan's experiment, then we'll find what was the findings of these experiment and by the other scientists. So inheritance patterns in general we will discuss, and finally we'll conclude our discussion with the sex limited characters. So firstly, we just want to see that what is the meaning of sex-linked inheritance. So firstly, the introduction part that we can see. There are few characters which are basically linked to the sex. That means if the genes related to a particular characters are located on sex chromosomes, these characters are called sex-linked characters. For example, in human beings, there are two kinds of sex chromosomes, X chromosome and Y chromosome. Okay. The Y chromosome's characters are basically limited to male individuals. Since there is no Y chromosome in the females, so definitely Y linked equals to Y limited characters or the sex limited characters. So this is the sex limited characters. And since we know that there are two X chromosome in the females, so the females can be homozygous for the sex linked character or the heterozygous. But male individuals cannot be homozygous or heterozygous since they are provided with only single X chromosome. So most of the sex-linked characters are the X-linked characters, okay, and their inheritance due to the differential distribution of the sex chromosome among the different sexes, their inheritance pattern is quite different from the autosomal characters. The sex-linked inheritance has been unraveled firstly by the Morgan's experiment while he was conducting his experiment on the Drosophila melanogaster, that is the fruit fly. He surprisingly found that among the red-eyed Drosophila, which are the normal one, few are white-eyed individuals. So he just wanted to see whether these white-eyed Drosophila are the mutant one or due to some sort of specific inheritance pattern. So what Mendel did, he conducted cross between pure line red-eyed females and pure line white-eyed males and found that in the F1 generation, all the males and the females are red-eyed. This was in consistence with the Mendel's principle of dominance. He then allowed the F1 to cross among themselves to produce the F2 generation. And he found that all the females in the F2 generation are red-eyed, but 50% males are red-eyed and 50% are white-eyed. So he proposed that since the character is distributed differentially among the different sexes, he proposed that these characters should be sex-linked and that sex-linked characters should be present on X chromosome. So what was his experiment? We can see in the diagram. In this diagram, we can say the two flowcharts, the A and B. In the A flowchart, the original Morgan's experiment was there, in which the red-eyed female has been crossed with the white-eyed male and the F1 generation that has been produced contain all the males or the females are red-eyed. He then produced the F2 generation in which 50% males are white-eyed and 50% are red-eyed, while all the females were red-eyed. So, surprisingly, we can see in the first generation, white-eyed male is there. In the second generation, there is no white-eyed male. In the third generation, among again white-eyed male. So, it's a kind of pattern that is generated. And he was then of the view that definitely it is not due to the mutation, rather than it is a kind of specific inheritance pattern. So he just wanted to verify his findings that whether the sex-linked characters are X-linked characters or not. He proposed and conducted a reciprocal cross. That means reciprocal means we just want to change the characters or shuffle the characters among the parents. So in the B bar, we can see that he crossed white-eyed females with the red-eyed males. Both are the pure line that we can see in the diagram. And then he found in the F1 generation that here there is an appearance of a white-eyed male that was not consistent with the original experiment. So here is the first difference. That means we can see the reciprocal crosses do not produce the same kind of result in the F1. He then proceeded his experiment to the F2 generation and found surprisingly that 50% females are white-eyed and 50% are red-eyed. While same pattern is followed for the males. 50% are white-eyed and 50% are red-eyed. That means it is a kind of inheritance pattern in which male of this generation transmits its character to the females of the next generation, and then females are transmitting their characters to again males and females of the next generation in this reciprocal. Here we can see the XW, W stands for the white-eyed male, then next generation female, then next generation male. So it is a kind of crisscross inheritance pattern that we will see. So by this experiment, we can conclude how the sex-linked characters are inherited. They are following some patterns. Firstly, the reciprocal crosses do not yield the identical results that we have seen already here. This is the reciprocal cross to this original cross. So here the results are quite different from the original one. And the results are different in both F1 generation as well as in F2 generation. Secondly, he found that the recessive genes show crisscross inheritance pattern. That means male transmitted sex-linked genes to all his daughters, who in turn transmit them to half of their males. Again, we can see the male transmit their characters to all the females, and they are transmitting half of the male generation, next generation. So that was the crisscross inheritance pattern. And finally, the important thing is the frequency of individuals showing recessive sex-linked traits is higher in heterogametic sex than is in the homogametic sex. Heterogametic sex means the two sex chromosomes are different, and homogametic sex means the two sex chromosomes are the same, as in the case of human females, and heterogametic sex as in the case of human males. So the frequency is higher in heterogametic sex. That means if we are talking about the human being, then definitely the frequency of sex-linked characters is higher in case of males. So what are the sex-linked characters in case of human beings? We can think of hemophilia, that we know very well that hemophilia is of two types, depending on the absence of clotting factor. Clotting factor 8, if it is found defective or the absent, then it is called type A hemophilia. And if the factor 9 is absent, then it is called type B hemophilia. So what happens in the hemophilia? Due to the lack of clotting factor, the bleeding cannot be stopped. So the person dies of anemic situation. Secondly, red and green color blindness. Color blindness also includes blue color blindness, but blue coloration is basically governed by autosomal genes rather than the sex-linked genes. But the red and the green colors are basically determined the gene located on the X chromosome. Next one is the Duchenne type muscular dystrophy. It is a kind of muscular dystrophy in which the muscles are not working well, and it is also the sex-linked characters. And that means all these are following the crisscross inheritance patterns. And we know very well that hemophilia, as well as color blindness, as well as Duchenne type muscular dystrophy, have higher frequency in case of males than that of the females. Next, Leishman syndrome, in which the HGPRT gene is defective, so such kind of syndrome is produced, and another one is Hunter syndrome. Now we are moving to then the sex-limited characters. How the sex-limited characters differ from sex-linked characters? As we have seen in the very first slide here, the modern scientists define Y-linked characters as the Y-limited or the sex-limited characters, because that character is limited only to male, because the Y chromosome is limited only to males. The sex-limited characters are basically the characters which are found only and only in the one of the sex, not two of the sexes. Here, important thing is many of the characters are located on the autosomes, not on the Y or not on the X chromosome, rather than on the autosomes. But their hormonal differences are such that they govern the development of such characters in such a way that some characters are produced only in one of the sex, not in the other sex. For example, the primary and the secondary sexual characters found present in the males. So that is the sex-limited character. So it can be defined as those characters whose development is limited to only one of the sex are called sex-limited characters. While we have seen that in sex-linked situation, sex-linked inheritance or sex-linked characters are basically governed by the genes which are located on the X chromosome, not on the autosomal characters. So that we have completed all those discussions regarding the sex-linked inheritance and the sex-limited inheritance. In crux, we can simply say sex-linked characters are governed by X chromosome, while the sex-limited characters are governed by autosomes. And since autosomal inheritance pattern is the same as of other autosomal genes, so sex-limited characters are following autosomal route of inheritance, while the sex-linked characters are following the crisscross kind of inheritance pattern, in which the reciprocal crosses do not yield the same results. In case of sex-limited characters, since following the autosomal route of inheritance pattern, they are following the reciprocal crosses as same result as usual. Okay. Thank you so much. It's all about the sex-linked characters and sex inheritance. Sex-limited characters. Stay happy, stay blessed. Thank you. Thank you so much.